take a minor little break because SB wants some tummy tickles. Demands tummy tickles, and the tummy tickles she shall receive. These tummy tickles are only possible thanks to everyone who has followed the stream. I tell you, they give... Tummy tickles do not grow on trees. I don't just randomly give them out whenever she throws herself to the ground in tummy tickle position. I wait for you guys to give me the go-ahead. I'm just kidding. Every time she throws herself, I don't care if she's on the other end of the apartment or on the couch or on my face, I give her tummy tickles. But your follows still bolster the tickle power of the tummy tickles. I know this is not a plug for following. I'm saying thank you for following. To anyone who is watching, who has followed, thank you so much.
Hi.
She's a good girl. She just, again, has an overactive chomp. Chomp. I can't think of a cute phrase. Because, you know, with a lot of these things with the kitties, I think of cute phrases like kitty coins and tummy tickles. Drive-by fuzzins. Kitty... kitty nibbles. Like their food. I call them goosums and... woozy woozums and... I don't know where some of those words came about, but... like some of those nicknames, I don't know where those came about. I just started calling them the Goosey Woozums. Or the Gazumba. I call SB the Gazumba all the time. I don't know what that means, but I love it. Okay. What are we doing? Sorry. Let's see here. Collect. What is this? This is what we have there. Okay. Greedy Mark score of 3681. Now we're getting into the heavy stuff. That's what I like to hear. Remove viruses. Okay. So now we have to actually study what can make his PC get a score of 3681. Now I hope we don't have to scrub through all 121 pages of the manual to find that. But we will see what happens. Ooh, that's very pretty. Oh my goodness. Oh, where's your Koza Boomza? Where's the Koza Boomza? Virus scanner. There we go. Aww. It's a kitty and a puppy. It's a fuzzy goose. Okay, 400. Okay. Good. We got it. Okay. Power down, pick up. Throw away.
Throw away, Master Wayne.
Let's see. I'm confused. Did I not do the right thing? Where's the Where's their PC? I don't... Okay. Oh, we got that done, I think. Oh, we got that done. Okay. Good. Did we already... Not... What's going on? I am not... Where did their computer go? Oh, maybe I just... Okay, sorry. That's something I didn't take into consideration. Decent antivirus software. Honestly, I don't think antivirus software is as necessary nowadays. The onboard Windows Defender software is good enough, I think, for most people's needs. That's what I've heard. I haven't had antivirus software since I got this computer, and I have not had an issue. I've just been using Windows Defender, and it's fine. Your name is, very confusing. I think it's supposed to be Extreme Psycho, but I'm reading it as Extremes Pico. Welcome to the stream. Do you know stuff about PCs? You know what? I'm like pants in here. I am pantaloons. I am also learning, but I know a little about PCs. Sounds like we all do, and that's good. PC running really slow. I'm so confused. I had leveled up. Level 5. Yay! What's up, Extreme Psycho? How's it going? Personally, I cannot stand modern technology. Intel i5, Core i5. Did the music get a lot louder for you guys? Like, are you still able to hear me? Intel Core i5 6400 or better. Not happening. We're going the base route. i15? Oh, that would be insane. 6400. Or better. Okay. And... I don't know whether to build one or get one pre-built. Or get a pre-built. You know, on the surface, it may sound better to get a pre-built because it's already done. You don't have to worry about all the things that, all the worries that come with building a PC. But honestly, the truth is, I say bite the bullet, because while the pre-builts are pre-built, they are overpriced. In a vast majority of cases, they are way overpriced for what they give you. You're more often paying for the brand than the actual components. So building one yourself would be a lot cheaper. And also if you buy a pre-built from like Best Buy, that's not a good idea. I swear to you, Best Buy has this contract that states all of their computers must be refurbished and they can't tell you about it or something, because every computer I've ever bought from them, doesn't matter if it was a Dell or an HP or MacBook, it's always crashed on me. It's always overheated immensely. It's always been just horrible. So I highly recommend building your own. But I understand if there's some trepidation with that, because when I first started getting parts for my PC, I was thinking this is it's too much to work with, too much to think about. It's scary, but I think it's one of those things that it's good that I bit the bullet. Plus, with pre-built PCs, well, never mind. Some pre-built PCs are okay about people opening them and being able to change things out. Some of them are not, though, so that's another thing to think about, because one of the best things about PCs is you can, in the future, upgrade things by yourself or on your own. So if you have your own PC, there's no warranty to worry about ruining. Like if you build your own, there's no warranty about removing the case or whatever. So I don't know. I think I can see why a pre-built would be a good idea. In fact, that was what I was looking at, but I was swayed totally the other direction when I found out that they're overpriced. They're Pre-builts are overpriced, and they're not. I've heard a lot of bad stories about them being unreliable, but that could just be conjectural bias from the PC master race. What was I buying? 8 gigs of RAM, that's right. 8. Okay, 8 gigs. That. And then, okay, so we got that. i5 6400. Titan XL 8 gig. Okay. Oh, accept it, probably. Good idea. Watching YouTube videos and visiting forums will get you on the right track as long as you take your time and be patient. Should be having a good experience. And to clarify, you're talking about building the PC as opposed to buying it pre-built. Wait, what? And make sure all your parts work with one another. Yeah. That's another thing. But, the good news is on that front, nowadays there are pretty good resources on that. And there are a couple places where you can put in your parts, and I think it'll tell you if there are any discrepancies, like if your CPU is the wrong socket type, or if your motherboard won't fit in the case, or if the cooler. Maybe that's a little too much, but maybe the cooler doesn't have enough clearance in the case that you have. There was something I think I heard about another. There was another pre-built PC that I saw where someone was talking about replacing the graphics card, and the graphics card they wanted to replace it with, was too big for the case. There are a lot of issues there. Thanks for the help with that hard drive. Yay! Would you believe I'm still struggling to find a replacement copy of Babes of Planet Baltimore? Best I've come across so far was a bootleg DVD. Laserdisc. Oh, interesting.